Well, people, this is what I found out about this killer here, Charles Schmuck. He's from Tucson, Arizona. I guess, like I said, he was an adopted child. Tried to get back with his real mother. She told him to not leave and never come back. If that tells you anything. The guy used to wear paper towels or something in his boots and crushed cans to make him seem taller in cowboy boots. And I don't know how he walked around all day with that. But that guy must have had a mind like a friggin'. Excuse me, rock. Brain dead is right. The guy had friends. He was kind of popular and everything. But due to the fact, for whatever reason, he wanted to know what it was like to kill. He ended up killing three girls. One in which was his girlfriend at the time. Because he killed another friend of hers. And, you know, she got spooked. And he didn't want her to tell, so he took her and her sister and strangled them to death. But the guy he met, one of his friends, got spooked also and went and ratted him out. So fate had its karma. And the guy got stabbed in jail 47 times, puncturing a lung. So karma's a bitch. He got back what he deserved. But all in all, reading up on this, the Miss Oates that was inspired by this guy. To write about him, and everything she wrote about was reality. From raping to, you know, murdering, anything she came up with, she grew up or saw or seen, she took it and wrote it. Multiple awards for literature and all kinds of stuff. And that, and the other guy that I looked up on and showed the other day, him too, writing all about, right, the riots and, or getting involved with violent things. Dang it. But this woman was asked, why does she write so much violence? And when you ask that question, man, it's like, wow. I mean, yeah, what I just read in her Wikipedia, it goes on and on about what she wrote about. Reality is what she wrote about. So then that other guy. But this woman to this day is still writing and tweeting now. She is still alive. Sticking up for Donald Trump at that. All kinds of quacky stuff. But, so it gives me a little bit of idea of what this guy in this, you know, man-made built shed in the woods was really reading about. I mean, that person wasn't already a supernatural ghost, but like my man Dave said, that is something to think about too. Things that are there that your mind sees but disappears. And there have been stories about that. People on Reddit talking about, like I said in my last video, towns that were there and then they disappeared. Johnny Walker, We're going to talk about booze right now. Jimmy Walker. Dynamite JJ. Had that encounter. I like to use him now. And watch another few episodes of Celebrity Ghost. And I got another interesting one. John Snyder. From one of my favorite TV shows. The Dukes of Hazzard. It's the good old boys, that's right. Waylon Jennings, people. You don't know that TV show, watch it. Awesome car chases. It's all I used to watch, that Dodge Charger. Race, chase, and escape. Loved it. But, what this person doing in that shed with these kinds of books. Now, like I said, I still gotta find out what the books were on the show. I mean, the secret one was kind of weird. Didn't come up with the same title, but came up with some other info I gotta go over. And also, when I find out what this woman's book was, I'm still fine trying to figure out the title, but I can't because of the damn glare of the light in the picture. I almost got it, but I haven't found it yet, and I want to know what that book was about. So when I get them two cleared up, I'm going to do a video on that and see what this person was really getting involved or what he was piecing together, if it was, say so, a serial killer, you know, not bringing their victims there because, right, I wasn't thinking about all the blood and, you know, cleaning up that because that would have been there. So that was more like a retreat, so say, reading them books, getting ideas type of thing, which is what I think. So, not to bring his victims there, but to be in a retreat. And, wait a minute, I got a multi-person out here. You got a problem? Yeah, here's your problem. Stuff that down your mouth. I don't know, some about that garbage can over there. Really wants to make me mad. Always got something to say when I drive up. So, I got to put in that dirty cup for its dirty mouth. I'm losing it. But, anyways, that's what I think that place was, if it was a serial killer. So, I mean, yeah, to be up there and getting all his bizarre thoughts, getting all what he was getting ready for on his next victim, whatever it took, whatever it may be. And, Getting himself prepared for that next murder. That's what I think that was all about. And if they're reading books like this, or even gotten to that serial killer, well, the guy killed 3 people, but it does make him kind of a serial killer, so, or a killer. So, I mean, for this guy to be reading up on stuff like that, maybe he's getting ideas to do something to the next victims up there masterminding the plan. And what better place to do that out in the woods by yourself in a secluded shed? Hold that thought, I'll be right back. So, that being said, masterminding a plan to be something. And what better place out in the woods, secluded, left with your own thoughts, left with a book to read, pretty much on how to kill. Who knows if he was gonna make the next riots? I mean, both them books were based on, I mean, both them authors did a lot of the, were, you know, raised throughout the 60s, so a lot of controversy going on back then, boy. And don't get me wrong, always something happening, but them were really taken to the extreme. Like all them riots, and I mean, it's kind of good that we don't get much riots here anymore, but when we do, it's pretty much stupid. Oh yeah, oh no, my team lost. I'm gonna talk about going from something back in the day to, oh, my sports team lost. Let's flip a car. Let's do this. Let's do something dumb. I mean, come on. We're gonna do something real. Original. Something stupid. But I don't recommend anybody to do that, but it's just crazy, though, just to think that this guy was in the woods and could have been in the woods that many years. And how many people he could have taken out. But like I said, that guy out there talking about, well, I haven't been in this part of the woods since 1985. Just crazy. To have that camp just disappear like that, that's even more insane. But it is what it is. We're not gonna get rid of all the creeps in the world, so you just gotta be more prepared in life. Outless last night I was watching started watching some videos. I've been doing a lot of music playing, video watching lately, seeing what comes up for more videos, other people's opinions, but came across Uncle Ted. That's right, Mr. Ted Nugent. In his interview he did in 2011, I think I did watch that when it came out in 2011. And he's with that British guy. Oh yeah, it got heated, and I just reminiscing to what he was saying about gun control. He tries telling the highly apologize for my voice. I know someone complained about my voice one day, coughing, got distracted with the coughing, but sorry, I can't help it. I try to keep my voice as clear as possible, but God damn, this pisses me off. But, yeah, talking about gun control and being safe. And I mean, you think about it, you got people like this hanging around the woods. You got people every day out there going after people. There was just a guy in an Uber car watching the news last night. A guy was supposedly sick with his stomach, going to the hospital. But he's got enough balls to get cocky in the back seat. And the girl he's with got enough balls to get cocky to the Uber driver. You know, he's saying, you know, if you're gonna keep this up, man, I gotta let you out right here. And poof! Immediately the guy goes from sick to slamming the dude in the back of the head with his fist. Bang, 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 bang! So he's sitting there trying to defend himself. Drove until he could pull over. And then, you know, of course, the two chumps in the back got out and ran. But why you gotta rag on an Uber driver? Oh, that's what he was doing. The guy was telling him to go faster. Oh, go faster. Oh, I'm sick. Oh, he's crying like a little bitch in the back seat that I'm sick. Drive faster. The guy's telling him, I can't, man. Can't you see the cars? You know, I gotta drive with the traffic. You can't just bump that. My kid does that to me. You wanna talk about this guy's brain radius? An IQ. My kid tells me that. Oh, drive faster. We gotta get there. Drive faster. Ah! always tell them, you know, you got to teach your kid. How am I going to drive faster when I got 12 cars in front of me and we're all going 25 miles an hour? Shut up, you little shit. So I'll be telling them, right? So this idiot, right? Oh, drive faster. Oh, that's why he's getting cocky to drive faster. The guy said, if you keep this up, man, you know, they were getting mouthy with him and everything. I have to drop you off. A perfect example, just started wailing on the back of his head. Boom, 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 boom. Punch, 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 punch. I mean, the guy was took some pretty bad blows. And this little piece of crap in the back seat was able to get full swings. You know, some of these cars are wide enough. But looking at the poor bastard, sick man. It's kind of like to say, I wish I was there on the sidewalk. I'd have ripped that guy out of that car. Beat the friggin' holy shit out of him. The fuck you doing, stupid? But it's only safe to say, oh man, everybody needs protection. Whether it be self-defense, whether it be a gun. Guns don't kill people. People kill people. Stupid people. So, I mean, anyways, just to think this guy been out there, who knows how long, guy or woman, but more or less, you gotta keep thinking. And guys like this, all of a sudden one day say, what the world's like to kill somebody, duh. And this guy was supposedly intelligent too, Mr. Charles. He sent poetry to a college professor, and the guy actually took it in. I guess he used it. But I think how I read it, sounded like he regretted using it. But it's like, wow, using a killer's friggin' poetry. But then again, look at Charles Manson. Guns N' Roses in the Spaghetti Incident took a song that he wrote, played it on the album. Whichever that Spaghetti Incident album, what it means. But Axl Rose was a Charles Manson fan. I don't know if he liked him, but of course you'd see him in concerts with wearing a shirt. I think maybe he must have liked his intelligent side, which he did write a good song, don't get me wrong. For him to keep that going, though, and just to think of what he's done. And the story, man, always gets me all the time. Wanting to join the Beach Boys. Oh, man. Just think of Charles Manson and the Beach Boys. I mean, in a way, you kind of sit there and think, geez, guys, if you would have let him move in on the band, maybe he wouldn't have been a killer. But I wouldn't put that guilt on them guys. They're good. I like the Beach Boys. Especially when Jackie Chan's, oh, Beach Boys, you ever touch a black man radio? Anyways, I gotta make light of a story that's just so sick and twisted. Whatever this guy may be thinking, if he's still out there building his cabin in the woods, preparing for his next murder, whatever it may be. These are just my thoughts and theories. I'm going over this story, man. Insane what the guy's reading out there, so. Only one can know, of course, what their mind's thinking when they're secluded in the woods. A lot of dark things happen in the woods, even though I like them. I like to go out there myself. That's right. Take them serial killers and kill them out there. That's what I'd like to do. Stupid sons of bitches. Anyways. Like I always say, take care, beware. always beware. Be safe. Till the next video. Got lots of stuff coming up. I've been so out of focus on things, man, because the friggin' holiday went by. I haven't been getting much videos out there, but trying my damnedest to get some. Yeah, just been damn busy. Ugh. Sucks. But I got some comics I want to come up with and some... do some comedy... pay tributes. I got some tributes coming up. Because I've been watching some stuff, keep my mind focused. Trying to stay happy and not depressed. Ha! But until the next video, we'll see you then. Out.